Namaste everyone, welcome to this virtual class sponsored by Siddharth Iswar. I'm Ganesh Raut, and today again I would like to continue the same topic, tense. Dear students, we discussed a study on the origin of tense. Where was tense originated from? And when? We saw that. At the same time, we also talked on its divisions, types, kinds. Today, I would like to discuss on simple present tense. Simple present tense. Okay. Dear students, simple present tense, the study of simple present tense is in three categories here. I would like to divide the study of simple present tense in three categories. And the first, we'll talk about its concept. Concept, then structure, then usage. Yes. So, let's talk about the concept of simple present tense. What is simple present tense? How do we understand that it is simple present tense? The sentence is in simple present tense. Dear students, I would like to give you a short diagram here. See here. Okay. This is a line in mathematics. I would like to point out the center as present time. Suppose that this point is present time. From here to left, past. And from here to right, future. See here. Dear students, please have your concentration over here on the picture. You will understand. See here. What I mean to say here, action, work. So what does this picture signify? This picture says that the action takes place at present here. Exactly. Simple present tense means the action which takes place at the moment, now, at the time of speaking. The tense denotes such action. Which action? Action, let's say work, that happens or occurs. It was UIs occurs at present, at the moment, or at the time of speaking. Is to be in simple present tense. Is to be in simple present tense. Okay. This tense, write down these two. So, what do you mean by simple present tense? Then you say, must say. Simple present tense denotes an action that happens at the time of speaking. At the moment, at present now. That action is to be in simple present tense. Okay. Now, second, we'll talk on the structure of this. What's the structure of simple present tense? The structure is subject plus V1 or V5 plus C here. Subject here may be both in singular form or plural form. Yes, that's strange. Remember this. This V1 verb's first form. This is used with plural. Plural subject. I'll show you the example too. Whereas this V5 is used with singular subject. I mean, if you have a singular subject, then V5 is used. Plural subject, then V1 is used. Let's see one example. Hurry, read, or reads a book. My dear students, now let me know which verb is appropriate here with the subject hurry. Hurry is singular. So which one is singular here, read or reads? Dear students, if we add yes or yes in verbs, the verbs become singular. So, this is singular. So, this is the answer here. If you write read, it's wrong. Hari reads a book. Because this is singular and the verb is also to be singular here. Let's see one example here. Ram and Sham. Okay. Work or works together. See. Now, what's the subject here? Ram and Sam. It's plural. And dear students, plural subject is V1. So this is works is the wrong answer over here. Yes. So, what can you be said in conclusion here? Singular subject, singular verb. Plural subject, plural verb. See here. You write here, please. This is the formula for you. Singular subject, the singular verb. Whereas plural subject, plural verb. Okay. Plural verb means V1 here and singular verb means V5 here. Okay. Dear students, let's see some pronouns here. How are the verbs used with pronouns? Now, right down. First person, I. We is plural form, you second person, and plural of third person, they. With these all four, we use plural verb. Plural verb is used. Okay, V1 is used. Whereas, Third person singular like he, she, and it. We use singular verb. Singular verb. That's the five here. Yes, see one example. I play football. Though I is singular, it takes plural verb. Okay, it is in the exceptional case. You go there. See here. You a viewer. I viewer. But she writes a letter. She here. She singular? The five here. Singular? The five here. So his heart is about structure there. Subject plus V1 or V5. V1 is used with plural subject. V5 is used with a singular subject. Yes. The subject is singular, the verb is to be singular. If the subject is plural, verb is to be plural. Dear students, I would like to take you back to the numbering system of nouns and verbs there. Dear students, the numbering system of nouns and verbs is quite opposite of one another. See here, I would like to show you here. Numbering system. A verb first, eh? Okay, noun first. Let's write here. Book. Yes? Is it singular or plural? Singular. Now write yes. Now, it's equal to books. Now this is plural. See? So, what has happened over here? If we add yes in noun, the noun becomes plural. Next example. Pen. Singular and yes. Called pens. Now plural. But it is just opposite in verb. See here, verb, one verb. Read. This is a verb. This is a plural verb, dear students. Now, add yes here. Yes. Now, what is this? Reads. Now, this has become singular here. See, its numbering system is quite opposite of this. Isn't it? Yes. Similarly, right. It's human. It's plural. Now, right, yes here. Now, it became rights. It is singular. So, the numbering system of nouns and verbs is quite positive one another. Dear students, after this now, we talked about the concept, we talked about the structure. Now, we will talk on the uses of simple present tense there. Okay? So, let's talk on that too. Now, for that, let me rub this please. Okay, now this is very important, by the way, uses of simple present tense. Okay. Uses of simple present tense. This is the backbone of grammar. Tense is the backbone of grammar. Without tense, it is difficult. Dear students, so please, I suggest you to have your concentration over here on the board, please. If possible, write down, note. Let's see. Here I will give you type 1 examples. I'll give you examples first. Let's see. This sun arises in the east. Now tell me, which tense is used over here? Subject and verb. This is simple present tense. Why simple present tense? Is that the why video? So which sentence are apni simple present tense mein ramo lagse. Apni past ma ramo lagse. Apni passive ma ramo lagse. To ti anusar lekhnu parne insanle. See here. Which tense is this simple present tense? Why? Son, subject, V5 is here. This is V5 and subject. This is talk of simple present tense. So why simple present tense here? What is the reason? I'll come over here later. Let me give you another example. The earth moves round the sun. See here. Again, tell me which sentence tense is used over there. Good. Simple present tense. Define is here. Subject is here. Very good. Let's see. Stars twinkle at night. Now tell me. Subject. You are. Simple present tense. Why simple present tense over here? Dear students, if you go to the meaning of core meaning of these sentences, these three sentences denote truth. They denote universal truth. Eternal truth is there. This truth cannot be changed at all. The sun always rises in the east. The earth always moves around the sun. Stars always shine at night there. I mean, these denote universal truth. Universal. It's also called eternal. Eternal truth. Yes, dear students. That's why they are to be in simple present tense. You cannot write this sentence in other tense. If you write, it becomes wrong. You cannot ever say, the sun will rise in the east. Can we write? Never. Wherever they are to be in simple present tense. Not only with these three sentences, with all universal truth, eternal truth, simple present tense is used there. So this is what you understood over here with these three examples. With the eternal truth, with the universal truth, the truth which can't be changed, the truth that is forever from generation to generation. That sort of truth is to be in simple present tense, not in other tense there. Okay. Now, type 2 examples, let's see. Type 2 examples. Okay, dear students, see here, light travels faster than sound. Yes, now tell me, which tense is used over there? Good, simple present tense. If I am there. Okay. Next is water freezes at 0 degree centigrade. Which tense is here? Why? Tem aonde, senhor? Que não? Mal deixa. Então, sempre presente tense de uso aí. In every action, science ka vidyarthi haru, in every action, there is equivalent opposite reaction. Opposite reaction. What is the tense used over here? Simple present tense. Now, let's analyze. Let's study these examples here. Why simple present tense with these examples? Because, dear students, they denote, they are scientific theories. They are scientific principles. These theories and principles have been developed by science in the course of time. They are scientifically verified. वैज्ञानिक रूपले प्रमाणित गरिएको कुरा हो साइन्टिफिक ट्रुथ भन्छु म यसलाई साइन्टिफिक ट्रुथ दैट्स व्हाई दे आर टू इन सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस बिकॉज़ दे आर अ सॉर्ट ऑफ ट्रुथ एक किसिमको सत्य हो वैज्ञानिक सत्य लाई भन्छ त्यसैले हामी के बोलौ विथ द साइन्टिफिक प्रिन्सिपल्स एन्ड थ्योरीज Scientific principles and theories. We use simple present tense. This is the second point you have understood here. First words with eternal and universal truth, simple present tense is used. Second is with the scientific principles and theories. Simple present tense is used there. Because they too denote a kind of truth. They are experimentally verified. Okay. So, let's see type 3 examples. I'll rub this, okay? Let's see. Type 3 examples. Type 3 examples. Okay. Top 3 examples. Okay. Blood is red. Blood is red. See here, dear students, what the tense we used over there? Simple present tense. This is subject. This is V5. Okay, a mother loves her child. A mother loves her child. Which tense is used here, dear students? Oh, very good. Simple present tense. Mother subject loves the verb in the V5 form. Let me give you one more example here. A triangle has three sides. A triangle has three sides. Yes. What's the tense here? Again, simple. This is B5, right? Subject. Now you guess. Why? Why are they to be in simple present tense? Can these sentences be written in other tense? Can we write here, the blood will be red? The blood was red? Never. We write wrong. It is 100% wrong. Why? Because these three denote inherent qualities, inherent characteristics. These are the characteristics of redness is the characteristic of blood. It is mother's characteristic to love her child. It is a feature of triangle to have three sides there. You try ट्रायंगल को विशेषता हो तीनटा साइड हुनु पर्यो त्यसको क्यारेक्टरिस्टिक्स हो डियर स्टुडेंट्स व्हाइल डिनोटिंग द इनहेरेंट क्यारेक्टरिस्टिक्स इनहेरेंट प्रिन्सिपल्स वी यूज सिंपल प्रेजेंट Inherent, right here, inherent characteristics or principles. Yes. With this, to denote such by birth characteristics, we use simple present tense here. Simple present tense is only to be used. We cannot use other tense with these inherent characteristics. Bitter gourd is bitter. Sugar is sweet. Can you like sugar? What sweet? Are why? Sugar as open is sweet, as open is sweet, open will open sweet. The truth ho. And truth is always in simple presentation. So, kuni sentence, simple present tense, but take that again. यसलाई अरू टेन्समा लेख्नु हुँदैन कुरा बुझ्नुपर्छ भाइ बहिनीहरू ओके अब आइम टु द लास्ट अफ दिस क्लास लेट्स सी टाइप फोर इक्जाम्पल्स टाइप फोर इक्जाम्पल्स ओके लेट्स सी इक्जाम्पल्स हियर वर्ल्ड इज गोल्ड World is gold. Oh, sorry, gold. Which tense is there? Simple present tense. Okay. A bad carpenter quarrels with his tools. What tense is used over here? Simple present tense. See here. Subject, reply. Honesty is the best policy. Honesty is the best policy. Dear students, simple present tense. Policy. CY. Okay, CY. Policy. Okay. What is the reason? Why are they simple present tense? Is there any special reason? Yes. The reason is they denote the truth of society. Social truth. Samajik satya. Kya hum social truth bol rahe hain? Social truth. Samajik satya. Society has proved this. Ki samaj le pura provide gai sakeko cha. Matlab that is also kind of truth. That's why they are to be in simple present tense, dear students. By the way, they are proverbs and sayings. Proverbs and sayings. Ukhan ho. Kase ko banai ho. Ukhan teti ke bande hai na. Is samaj ne pramanit gare pachi banne pura ukhan ho. That's why they are also to be in simple present tense. So, dear students, that's all for today. But tomorrow, I'll continue the same topic. Uses of simple present tense there. And thanks a lot for watching this virtual class of English grammar. Thanks a lot.